On to the latest coming in from the UK, British Prime Minister Boris Johnson is all set to present the contentious and highly anticipated Brexit bill in the British Parliament on Friday. A spokesperson for the Prime Minister confirmed the development, considering the fact that Brexit is supposed to happen next month. This attempt to expedite the process of the exit of Britain from the European Union has been called as a step in the right direction by many. The spokesperson said, and I'm quoting, "We plan to start the process before Christmas and will do so in the proper constitutional way in discussion with the Speaker." Following the victory in the British elections with an overwhelming margin last week, Boris Johnson vowed for a swift and speedy Brexit and delivery of the same. He said that that Brexit is now quote-unquote unstoppable.
We've got to get Brexit done, and there may have been a brief libation, because I think Brexit is now unstoppable. But we must get Brexit done. We must. We've had 3.5 years of wrangling, particularly about Brexit. It's time for us as a country to move on, and it's time for us to come together and deliver on our One Nation agenda. That's what I want to do.
However, his decision of Brexit was also facing serious backlash. Scotland's First Minister and SNP leader Nicola Sturgeon has reacted.
I was very firm with him that I have a mandate to offer people a choice. He reiterated his opposition to that. But, you know, let's focus on reality here. The election this week was a watershed moment for Scotland. Scotland very clearly wants a different future to the one that's been chosen by much of the rest of the UK, and Scotland wants to have the right to choose its own future.
Hello, everybody. Good evening.
With the elections now done and dusted and a handsome victory behind him, Boris Johnson is a man brimming with confidence. The newly elected Prime Minister has now approved the publication of a report on Russian interference in the UK. This is the same report which had been blocked by Boris Johnson before the elections took place on the 12th of December. The report, prepared by the Intelligence and Security Committee and presented to Prime Minister Johnson in October, Boris Johnson had come under fire for blocking the release of the report. The chair, Dominic Grieve, had described the decision as quote-unquote jaw-dropping, taking a dig at the timing of the decision. Grieve said that if Boris Johnson had done it now, he could have also released the report before the elections. The Prime Minister's official spokesman did not, though, reveal as to when the approval took place exactly. The Prime Minister's office has said the approval has been done in line with the Prime Minister's responsibilities under the Justice and Security Act 2013. The report is believed to cover Moscow's alleged efforts to exert influence in the UK through cash donations, political contacts and social media manipulation. Johnson's opponents had said that the document could contain embarrassing revelations about the Prime Minister and establish links between Russia and Brexit. Despite the approval, the report cannot be published under a new intelligence service committee until a new committee is appointed, and it is not expected to come out before January. And that massive defeat...